take the second model from coded inequalities, which is comparatively simple when compared to model number one. Here, we are not given with different symbols for each of the inequalities. Instead of that, the statements are directly given to us and we just need to check which of the conclusions are true. Now, the first example here is, the given statements are t less than r less than equal to u. The second one is l greater than u less than or equal to k. And the third one is p greater than or equal to r. And the two conclusions are k greater than or equal to r and the second one is l greater than r. So from these statements, we need to find out which of these conclusions are true. So as you can see here, we don't have different symbols which have to be replaced with inequalities and then find out the correct conclusions. Let us simply work out as we have discussed earlier and find out which of the conclusions are true. Now, if you look at conclusion number one, the variables k and r have been compared and the given conclusion is k is greater than or equal to r. Now, in the given statements, we have the variable k in statement 2 and the variable r in statement 1. So, before we compare k and r, we just need to see how to connect these two statements. To connect these two statements, we should have a common variable in between the two statements. And that common variable is nothing but the variable u. So, with the help of u, we can join these two statements and try to establish the relationship between k and r. So let us try to establish the relationship between k and r with the help of variable u. So if we try to read from this side, we know that k is greater than or equal to u. Remember, u is less than or equal to k. But when we go from the other side, we should say k is greater than or equal to u. So k is greater than or equal to u and u is greater than or equal to r. So we can say u greater than or equal to r. And from this, if we try to compare the variables k and r, we know that the definite relationship between them should be greater than or equal to, as we have two inequalities and both of them are same. So the obvious relationship between k and r is k greater than or equal to r, and that is given in conclusion number one. So conclusion one is true. Similarly, let us try to establish the relationship between l and r. Again, if you observe, the variable L is in the second statement and R is in the first statement. So we need to join these two statements with the help of a common link. And that link is nothing but the variable U again. So we can say L greater than U and U is greater than or equal to R. So U greater than or equal to R. Now from this statement, we know that if we apply rule number 2, that is, whenever we have similar inequalities, the common part should be considered as a relationship. So we can say L greater than R, and that is given in conclusion 2. So even conclusion number 2 is true. So the answer here should be both conclusion 1 and 2 are true. So as you can see here, there is not much of difference from model 1 to model 2. The only thing is we need to connect the given statements with the help of a common variable and then find out which of the conclusions follow. Let us take the second example based on model 2. The statements here are D greater than H greater than or equal to N, S greater than I less than or equal to H. The first conclusion is N less than or equal to S and the second one is I less than D. Now if we try to compare the two variables N and S, we find that N is present in the first statement and S is there in the second statement. So first we need to join these two statements with the help of a common variable. And that common variable should be the variable H, which is present in both the statements. So let us try to combine these two statements with the help of H. So we can say that N is less than or equal to H, H greater than or equal to I, and I is less than S. Now if we try to compare N and S, we know that in between N and S, we have got dissimilar inequalities. And from rule number 3, it is very clear that whenever we have dissimilar inequalities, the variables N and S cannot be compared. So here, the given conclusion should be taken as false because it says N is less than or equal to S. But N can also be greater than S. So conclusion number 1 is false. Let us now look at the conclusion 2. It says I is less than D. Let us now try to connect the variables I and D with the help of H. So we find I less than equal to H. H is less than D. H less than D. Now if we compare the variables I and D, we have two inequalities, less than equal to and less than. And very clearly we know that the relationship between I and D should be less than. That is the common part between these two inequalities. So we can say I is less than D, which is given in conclusion number 2. So conclusion 2 is true. So the answer for this question should be only conclusion 2 is true. Let us now take the third and the last example from model 2 of coded inequalities. The statements are H equal to I less than equal to R, M greater than equal to R, R less than S. The first conclusion is M equal to I and the second conclusion is M greater than I. So let us try to find out the relationship between M and I. As you can see here, M is in statement 2, I is in statement 1 and the connecting variable should be R as it is present in both the statements. So if we try to combine these two statements, we find that M is greater than or equal to R and R is greater than or equal to I. So we can say R greater than or equal to I. Now if you try to find out the relationship between M and I here, we have two inequalities. Both are greater than or equal to. So it is obvious that M should be greater than or equal to I. Now if you look at conclusion 1, it says M equal to I. Therefore, conclusion number 1 is false. As we know, M is greater than or equal to I. So we simply cannot say M is equal to I. The conclusion 2 is M greater than I. But here we know that M should actually be greater than or equal to I. So even conclusion number 2 is false, since it only considers the greater than inequality but not greater than or equal to. So conclusion number 1 and conclusion number 2 are false independently. But again, if you observe, if you combine these two conclusions, we come out with a relationship that M is greater than or equal to I. And that is what is the correct relationship between M and I. So we can say that conclusion number 1 and conclusion number 2 independently are false, but the combination of 1 and 2 has to be correct. So we can say that either 1 or 2 must be correct. So the answer for this question is either conclusion 1 or 2 is true. So friends, as you have seen in this session, the questions from coded inequalities can be solved with the help of the 3 golden rules that we have discussed in the beginning of the session. So whatever be the type of question, just try to follow the given rules and you can get the answer in a very easy manner. That's all from coded inequalities. See you in the next session. Thank you.